Kindly allow me to speak on this.
Okay, okay.
Madam, I rise to speak on the Consumer Protection Amendment Bill 2018, which was enacted in the year 1986. Madam, the emergence of global supply chain, rise in global trade and rapid development of e-commerce have led to a new delivery system for goods and services, and also provided new options and opportunities for consumers. Equally, it has rendered the consumer open to new forms of unfair trade and unethical business practices. Misleading advertisement, telemarketing, multi-level marketing, direct selling and e-commerce have created a new challenges to consumer protection that will require appropriate redressal to prevent consumer detriment. It is therefore commendable that government has embarked on modernizing the legislation on consumer protection, thus keeping pace with the changes in market to ensure the fair, equitable and consistent outcomes for consumers. Madam, Consumer Protection Amendment Bill 2018 seeks to replace the earlier act in order to address the emerging consumer concern in the present day scenario. The bill enforces consumer rights and provides some mechanism for redressal of complaints regarding defects in goods and deficiency in services. Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission will be set up at the district, state and national levels for adjudicating consumer complaints. Appeals from the district and state commission will be heard at the next level and from the national commission by the Supreme Court. The bill sets up a central consumer protection authority to promote, protect and enforce consumer rights as a class. It can issue safety notices for goods and services, orders refund, recall orders and rules against misleading advertisement. The bill has several provisions aimed at simplifying the consumer dispute adjudication process of the consumer dispute redressal agencies, besides enabling consumer to file complaints electronically. Madam, the bill sets up the Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission as quasi-judicial bodies to settle the dispute. The bill empowers the central government to appoint the members to this commission, but the bill does not specify that the commission will have a judicial member. If the commissions were to have members only from the executive, the principle of separation of powers may be violated. The bill confers power the central government to appoint, remove and prescribe condition of service for members of the district, state, national consumer dispute redressal commissions, but the bill leaves the composition of the commission to the central government. Madam, this can affect the independence of the quasi judicial bodies. The bill sets up the consumer protection councils at district, state, national level as advisory bodies. State and national councils are headed by the minister in charge consumer affairs, but the bill does not specify that who will advise these councils. If the councils will advise the government, it is unclear on what basis such advice will be given. Madam, the bill proposes severe penalty for the manufacturers and the service providers for false and misleading advertisement, including a fine of up to rupees 50 lakh and jail up to 5 years. However, the implementation process needs clarity. What is misleading and who will define what is misleading? Explicit guideline is may be required that what is misleading and what is not. Madam, the bill states that penalty can be imposed on the endorser who could be a celebrity. But the provision of imprisonment is not applicable to the endorsers. celebrities are not liable to the jail term under this bill and will also be protected by the indemnity bond that they signed with the brand. The bill further states that penalty has to be determined the population, the area affected by offences, frequency and duration of offences, vulnerability of the class of persons likely to be adversely affected and the gross revenue generation from the sales. It states that no endorser will be liable to a penalty if he or she has exercised due diligence to verify claims. Madam, there is no clarity on how an endorser can verify due diligence. This can create a regulatory loopholes and keep the celebrity out of the purview of the prescribed penalty. Madam, this bill, on the one hand, this bill has severe penalty provision for the endorsers, and on the other, it is giving them a route to get away because the clause of due diligence will act in their defense. This clause appears to negate the penalty provisions of this bill and may not serve the purpose for which it has been proposed. Madam, the bill puts the onus on celebrity to verify the correctness of claims regarding the goods and services before endorsing the same. If they fail to do so, celebrities may be prohibited from making any advertisement for any product or service for 1 year, extendable to 3 years for every subsequent contravention. It will act as a deterrent for a number of manufacturers when it comes not just to communication but more importantly adulteration of products. Madam, the other hurdle with implementation and the concept of misleading is that there is no repository for the consumers where the consumers or celebrities can verify the claims. Where will the consumer go if they have a specific query? Many consumers now do that on social media and some brands do respond. But what is the recourse of the consumers when brands do not respond? How can the consumer verify that what a brand is claiming it is genuine? Even the celebrities cannot verify the same if the consumer cannot do so. A formal reservoir of knowledge on products and brands would be necessary where the consumer can verify the claims. Lastly, madam, considering the impact of celebrity endorsement on consumer products, consumer choice situation is more damaging in case of advertisement of food products. Because this can impact on public health. Madam, popular food and beverage high in salt, sugar or fat content, which have been advertised by the celebrities, and including products like noodles, potato chips and digestive biscuits, etc. Some of these often been positioned healthy food alternative. Madam, people tend to see highly only positive highlighted in any products and not the negative potential impacts. For example, for noodles, it is advertised as a whole grain food with real vegetable. Nowhere it is mentioned that instant noodles have high salt and fat contents. Madam, celebrities or endorsers may also not be able to understand the scientific composition of the food products and the science behind the claims. Therefore, to deal with a situation like this, it is maybe a better option to ban the celebrity endorsement completely. With this, madam, I, on behalf of my party, support the bill and with hope that Honorable Minister will consider my points as I have raised here. Thank you.
Thank you.